Sit down, please. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله. اللهم صلِّ وسلِّم وبارِك على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه وأزواجه أمهات المؤمنين وعلى من اتبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين. إن شاء الله we're gonna come back to the kids story night. We had it before the corona and alhamdulillah Allah has saved us, so we decided to talk about the stories of the Sahaba, whether males or females. So inshallah, we're gonna try every week, whether myself, Sheikh Hamdi, or Sheikh Muhammad Morsi, inshallah, we're gonna try to have every Saturday kids story night and choose one companion, whether male or whether female, to talk about them. Move here, move here, move here. So we can learn about the Sahaba, inshallah. Our goal before Ramadan, I just want to let you know that, before Ramadan, we want to learn about 20 companions, 10 men and 10 women. Then we're gonna give you a test before Ramadan, and whoever answers the questions in writing, that's why I don't want you to come empty-handed. I want you to come with something that you write with. Alhamdulillah, Brother Hussein is recording this, so you can go and watch it later on tonight or tomorrow, and you can write the information. Because if you pass the test, then we're going to give you a big prize in Ramadan. The night of the 27th, we're going to give you a prize in Ramadan, inshallah. So you know the plan now. We have a long-term plan, which is learning about 20 companions before Ramadan. This is September. We have October, November, December, January, February, and maybe March, some of it. Inshallah. If we learn about 20 companions, then we're going to give you a test at the end. Whoever passes that test and scores good will be given big prize. I'm talking about big, big, big prize, not just candy. We're going to give you candy tonight if you do good, if you behave, if you listen, if you learn. But big prize in Ramadan, inshallah. But first, I want you to know, we say Sahabi, companion, disciple. Who are those? Who is a Sahabi? Who is a companion? That's the first question that I want you to answer and understand today. Who is he? Who is a Sahabi or who is a companion, guys? Who? Anyone knows? Ahmed? No, this is a name of a Sahabi. Yes, he was a Sahabi. But in general, who is a Sahabi? Hassan? Follower of the Prophet? That's it? Okay, anyone else? Yes? Somebody who's what? following you, okay? Don't look at the girls. Hey, look at me, eyes with me. Don't look at the girls. Yes, Sarah? Excellent. Takbir. Allahu Akbar. Say Allahu Akbar. Good job, Sarah. MashaAllah. So a sahabi, a companion, is someone who saw the Prophet with his eyes, even for a second. Even for 1 second. Even if he saw him from a distance and he did not speak to him. But he saw the Prophet and he became a Muslim and he died as a Muslim. So can we say that? Who's a sahabi? Someone who saw Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, became a Muslim and died as a Muslim. Three things. Who can say them? Who's a sahabi? Ahmed? Someone who saw the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and then he did what? Became. How do you become a Muslim? What do you say when you become a Muslim? أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وأشهد أن محمد رسول الله. And he died as a Muslim. Because some people may go back after that. Now, who's a Sahabi? Who's a Sahabi? Who can answer that? Yes. So the Prophet, number one. Two, accepted Islam. Three, died as a Muslim. Someone who saw the Prophet, say after me. Someone who saw Rasulullah, accepted Islam, died as a Muslim. Can you say this again? Who's a Sahabi? Who's a companion? Who's a disciple? Someone who saw? Saw Allah. Can we see Allah in this dunya? Who said Allah? We can see Allah in this dunya, guys. Come on. Someone who saw Rasulullah. Then what? Accepted Islam. Number three, he finished his life as a Muslim. We're good? I think we need to open up so we can start giving some nice candies. We have Twix. We have Snickers, Milky Way. We have M&M. And we have 55 pieces. That's all in here. All right? So I'm going to ask the question, Ahmed. I'm going to ask the question, and I want to give somebody some candy already. Oh, M&M came out. So who's going to say who's a Sahabi? Eeny, meeny, miny, moe. Catch a tiger by his toe. Baba Ali. كل برياني وانا قلت له عيالي تاني اوكي this young one here yes the one who had the glasses on and he took it off without me asking him he's very nice go ahead الله اكبر تكبير Come here. Come here. Allahu Akbar. Takbir. All right. Now take the glasses off now. I'm going to say take off. Can you say who's a Sahabi now? Say it in the microphone.
A Sahabi is somebody that saw the Prophet, became a Muslim, and died a Muslim.
What's your name?
Ahmed.
Ahmed. Masha Allah Ahmed. You get an M, the first M and M. All right. Good job. Okay. This second question is so easy. Who can answer it? I got Milky Way, and we need a girl to be fair. Hey, look at, don't look at the girls, man. Come on, man. Look at me. Eyes on me. Eyes on the Imam. Good man. Okay. What should we say when we know or when we hear a companion's name? What should we say? Can I finish the question, please? And I said one of the sisters is going to answer. Come on, guys. If we're not going to behave, are you a sister? Yeah. Are you a sister? I said one of the sisters is going to answer. Okay. When we hear a messenger name mentioned in front of us, what do we say? A messenger name. When we hear one of like Sayyidina Ibrahim, like Prophet Ibrahim, what do we say? Huh? What do we say when we hear a messenger name, guys? What do we say? Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Sayyidina Muhammad, what do we say? Sayyidina Ismail, sallallahu. Sayyidina Isa, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. What do we say when we hear a companion's name? What do we say? I said a sister, Ahmed. Are you a sister? Astaghfirullah. Okay, the sister in the one in the back there with her hands up. Abdurrahman, look this way. Don't look at the sisters. Come on. All right, go ahead. Mash, takbir. Allahu Akbar. So we say, radiyallahu anhu, if he's a man. But what if she is a female? What do we say? Where are you going? You got the M&M and leaving? Okay, come back. Take these glasses off. Why do you wear these glasses? Okay, if she's a girl, if she's a female companion, what do we say? Radiyallahu anha. Asma, like for example, Asma radiyallahu anha. Aisha radiyallahu anha. Umar radiyallahu anhu. Tayyib. Can I ask you another question? And the sister who answered. Give it to her, please. Okay, can I ask you a question? Abdurrahman, تعال هنا. تعال بعيد عنه. اقعد بقى هنا. Can we ask another question? Whoever answered this question, let me see here. He's gonna get Snickers. Why must we learn about the companions? I want you to think first. Why must we learn about them? Why? 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 So we can learn. That's a good one. Why must we learn about the companions, whether female or whether male companion? Why? Who can do it? Hassan. So we can follow what they did. That's a right answer. That's a right answer, but it doesn't qualify for a Snickers. It's good answer, but it doesn't qualify. I'm looking for something in particular. Something in particular. Okay, who can try? Why must we learn about the Sahaba? Why? Okay, the sister in the back there. Come on. Takbir! Allahu Akbar! Say Allahu Akbar! Is that Sumaya? You're Sumaya, good to see you. Hey. There you go, Sumaya. Why? Because who learned from the Prophet? Who saw the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? We didn't see the Prophet, did we? The Sahaba saw the Prophet. And when we learn about the Sahaba, we learn about the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Who heard the Quran from Rasulullah? Who? The first people to hear the Quran from Rasulullah? The Sahaba, right? Who saw the Prophet praying? The Sahaba. And they told us how he prayed, right? Also, they are the friends of Rasulullah. So we should like them, inshallah. Okay. I think we're doing okay with time. Let's move to our story tonight. I chose this companion because, subhanallah, I chose this companion, wallahi, because I love his story. He was living far away from Mecca. We know that the prophet was in Mecca, right? So he was living with his father and his mother in a place far away from Mecca. His mother one day wanted to visit her father. His father married his mother from another town. So the mother missed her father, and she said, I'm going to go and visit my father. And then she asked the father of Zayd, his name is Zayd ibn Haritha, his name is Haritha ibn Sharhil, al-Ka'bi, or al-Kalbi, min Quda'a. She said to him, I miss my father so much, and I wanted my father to see our son Zayd. Can I please take him to the other town in order for Zayd to meet his grandpa, to meet Giddu, because he misses his Giddu? Hannah بتقول لي جدو. The father agreed. The father said, yes, take Zayd and go and visit your father, and please have Zayd see his grandpa. So they got on a camel, nice camel, and they took with them some food, and they are driving the camel, or riding the camel. Do you drive the camel or ride the camel? Riding the camel. As soon as they arrived, Baba, she giving her Baba a hug. Giddu, how are you, Giddu? I miss you, Giddu. I love you, Giddu. I wanted to see you all the time, Giddu. I'm happy I'm here. Giddu was so happy. Grandpa was so happy to see his daughter and his grandson. And he made for them a real nice meal. And while they are eating, bad people attacked the city. Bad people attacked the city. They had swords, and they attacked everybody, started killing everybody in the city. Killing everybody. And they looked at Zayd. Oh, that little boy we can take and sell in the market so he can serve somebody. They took Zayd away. They killed the people. They took the money. And they took Zayd to a market where they sell people to serve other people. The mother was so sad. She started crying. My boy, I miss my boy. What am I gonna say to her father? So she went back to her husband, and she is in tears. Haritha, Haritha, the bad people took away our son. Oh, Haritha started crying. At this time, by the way, they didn't have 911. They didn't have Facebook. They didn't call somebody. They didn't report the matter. No way. The only way for them actually to get their message out is through poetry. Through poem. So Haritha started going around. He was so sad. I'm crying over my son Zayd. I love my son Zayd. I don't even know where he is. I just want to know whether he's alive or dead. His poem was so passionate, compassionate, effective, that the people started memorizing it. And his story got circulated around the Arabia. Oh, did you hear this father who lost his son? How he was crying over him And what was he saying? Man, this guy, we wish that this guy can. The bad people who attacked the village took Zayd. Guess how old was Zayd? 8 years old. He was a little boy. Subhanallah. They took him to a marketplace just for to sell human, called Souq Ikaz. And guess who bought him? The Prophet, by the way, is not a prophet yet. And he did not marry Khadija yet. The nephew of Khadija bought him. We know that later on the Prophet is going to marry who? Khadija. Her nephew, his name is Hakim ibn Huzam. Ibn Khuwaylid. Khadija, her name is Khadija bint Khuwaylid. She was his aunt. So Hakim went to the market and said, I need someone to serve me. I need someone to serve me because I need some help in the house. So he looked and he looked. That little boy Zayd looks good. I buy him from you. He bought Zayd. And he took him home. He went back to Mecca. This is how Zayd got to Mecca now, where the Prophet is. Now, guess what? Khadija went to visit her nephew, Hakim. And she started complaining to him, I have a lot of work in the house and I'm very busy. Because Khadija used to trade, used to be a businesswoman. She used to make money by trading. And I need someone to serve me. So, good idea. I just got this little boy from the market. What do you think? Yeah, I'll take him. And she took Zayd to her house. We know that later on the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam helped Khadija with her business. He actually went on one of the trips to sell and buy for Khadija. For Khadija liked the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, who was not a prophet yet, by the way. He never received the message yet. And later on, Khadija married Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam. They became husband and wife. So Khadija loved the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam. So she wanted to give him a gift. She said, what? I'm going to give you Zayd as a gift. You keep Zayd to help you, to serve you. This is how Zayd got into the company of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Subhanallah. Some people came from the hometown of Zayd, where his father is, to visit Mecca and make tawaf around the Kaaba. You know, people used to do that even before Islam, because this was a tradition of Prophet Ibrahim and Ismail. So as they are making tawaf around the Kaaba, this little boy is Zayd. This is the one his father is crying for him, saying all this point, come here, come here. Are you Zayd? Your name is Zayd. Your father is Haritha. Your father is looking for you, man. Where are you? Your father wants to see you. So, yeah, but I'm here staying with this nice man. His name is Muhammad ibn Abdullah. I'm staying with him here. You don't want to send a message to your father? No, I'm okay. I'm staying here. So when the people finished visiting Mecca, they went back to the father. Haritha, guess what? We found your son. Your son is in Mecca with a man called Muhammad ibn Abdullah. We saw him. We even shaked his hand. We even asked him, and he knew that you are the father. Really? My, you guys found my son? Finally, alhamdulillah, my son is alive. He collected a lot of money. And the father, Haritha, and he called upon his brothers. Brothers, come with me. Okay, let me take his son, his brothers as well with me. He took his brothers and Zayd brothers. And he went to Mecca. And he asked, where is a man called Muhammad ibn Abdullah? Where is he? Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Who was not a messenger yet, by the way. Where is he? Oh, he's living in that area. Knock, knock, knock. I am Haritha, and these are my brothers, and you have our son, and we know that you're a noble man. We miss our son, we love him, and want to take him back home. So can you please accept this money? We brought you a lot of money as a ransom to free him. Can you please accept this money and let Zayd go home with us? The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam did something very interesting. He said, I have a better choice for you, better idea. Bring Zayd and ask him, what does he want to do? Does he want to go home with you or does he want to stay with me? If he chooses to go home with you, take the money. I do not want money. I'll give him to you for free. No money. But if he want to stay with me, I can tell him no. They said, you are a nice man. You are a noble man. There is nothing better than this. Zayd, come. Do you know who this is? Yes, this is my father, Haritha, and this is my uncle, Ka'b ibn Sharhil, and those are my brothers. You know them? Yes, I know them. Those are my family. Okay, Zayd, you have a choice to go with them or stay with me. You decide. Zayd, without any hesitation, he said, by Allah, I will not choose anyone over you. Ya Muhammad. His son, his father looked at him, my son, you want to stay as a slave instead of coming back home with us? He said, by Allah, I have been living with this man for years and I have seen good things from him. He's a nice man. He's more than a father to me. He treats me so well. I feel very comfortable with him. I can't give him up. No. I know I love you, my father, but I can't give him up. This man is so nice to me. Haritha became upset. The father became upset. So the Prophet wanted to comfort him. So the Prophet took Zayd and he said to his father, please come with me. And the Prophet went in the court of the Kaaba. Ya Ahla Mecca, O people of Mecca, people of Mecca, bear witness that Zayd from this day on, his name is Zayd ibn Muhammad. He is my son. He inherits me, I inherit him. His father became comfortable that there is a good relationship going. But did Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala like that? No. Allah didn't like that. Allah didn't agree to that. Allah actually told the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, no. ادعوهم لآبائهم. Call them after the real fathers. Yeah, he may stay with you, but his name is Zayd ibn Haritha, not Ibn Muhammad. And Allah revealed the verses, ما كان محمد أبا أحد من رجالكم ولكن رسول الله. So Allah didn't like that, because this is the right of the Father. That's why we cannot call ourselves after anybody but after our own father and mother. So Zayd stayed with the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam until he became a messenger of Allah. Then they migrated to Medina. And after the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam fought the disbelievers three battles, Badr, Uhud, Al-Ahzab, the truce of Al-Hudaybiyah was established. So the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam decided to send messengers to the rest of the world, inviting them to Islam. So he sent a companion radiyallahu an by the name of Al-Harith ibn Umayr Al-Azdi to Malik Busra, or Sahib Busra, a place Busra, in the Roman area, in the Byzantine area. So they killed the messenger. So the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam decided to send an army, and he appointed Zayd to be the leader of this army. An army made of 3,000 only, to a place called Mu'ta, which is Jordan now, Mi'an area in Jordan. Subhanallah, the Roman prepared a huge army. Guess how many they were? 200,000. Imagine 3,000 facing 200,000. And Zayd, radiallahu anhu, was killed in this battle. Subhanallah, the battle was going on, and Rasulullah, Anas is the one who narrates this. Rasulullah was standing with the Sahaba in Medina, and Jibreel alayhi salam came to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, and he informed him that Zayd was killed. So he said to the Sahaba, أخذ الراية زيد فأصيب وعيناه تضرفان. And he was telling them while he was crying over Zayd. You know, Zayd had a son. His name is Usama. Usama ibn Zayd. They used to call him Al-Hib ibn Al-Hib. The title of Zayd is Al-Hib. You know what Al-Hib means? The most beloved by the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam. Aisha radiallahu anha, our mother, describes that one day the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was sitting with me, and he was not covering himself. He was wearing only undergarment. And he heard that Zayd is by the door. He forgot that he's not covered. He walked out and he hugged him. She said, I have never seen Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam so excited to see someone the way that he was excited about Zayd ibn Haritha radiallahu anhu. This is Zayd, you know, so beautiful. You know, if you want to go home with a lesson from that story today, some of us may have a misfortune. You know, imagine an 8 years old being taken away from his parents and sold in the market as a slave, subhanallah, but this led him to be what? A Muslim. Allah is the best of planners. You see, he was living out far away from Mecca, right? There is no way that he would have gotten to Mecca and became a Muslim except through that story. So we shouldn't be crying, oh, my family is this, that's not fair, like the kids of these days do. No, you know, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said what in the Quran? وَعَسَىٰ أَن تَكْرَهُوا شَيْئًا. Huh? Memorize this. وَعَسَىٰ أَن تَكْرَهُوا شَيْئًا وَهُوَ خَيْرٌ لَكُمْ. الأولانية عسى ولا وعسى؟ عسى أن تحبوا شيئا وهو شر لكم وعسى أن تكرهوا شيئا وهو خير لكم والله يعلم وأنتم لا تعلمون. Look at this verse in the Quran. You may love something. You may love something, but it's bad for you. And you may hate something, but it's good for you. Who knows this? وَاللَّهُ يَعْلَمُ وَأَنْتُمْ لَا تَعْلَمُونَ. Can you repeat that verse after me? عَسَىٰ أَن تُحِبُّوا شَيْئًا وَهُوَ شَرٌ لَكُمْ وَعَسَىٰ أَن تَكْرَهُوا شَيْئًا وَهُوَ خَيْرٌ لَكُمْ. هي كده مظبوطه ولا لا؟ كتب عليكم القتال وهو كره لكم وعسى ان تكرهوا شيئا وهو خير لكم وعسى ان تحبوا شيئا وهو شر لكم والله يعلم وانتم لا تعلمون. Can you say this after me? You may like something. I know this guy who loved a car called Ferrari or Lamborghini. I know a guy who loves Lamborghini. Lamborghini. I know some guy who loves Lamborghini. And all what he wants is Lamborghini. Lamborghini is a type of a car. He loves Lamborghini. You like Lamborghini or Porsche? You guys know about a car called Porsche? 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 Oh. And you say, oh Allah, give me Ferrari, oh Allah. I want Ferrari, oh Allah. Or Corvette. You guys see these Corvettes? Huh? And guess what? He loves that. It's good for him, right? Or I know someone who likes motorbikes, who want to drive motorbikes. And then he runs on the highway. The car flips over and over and over and over and over again. What happened to him? He Ferrari'd out. He Lamborghini'd. He's no longer alive. So somebody would ask, oh Allah, Ferrari, Ya Rab, and Allah will give you a small, tiny Ford or Hyundai, small car. Why, oh Allah? You see, when you drive that small car in the highway, you're going to drive slow, you're going to stay alive, and you're going to make more hasanat, right? So you may like Zayd. Zayd did not cry. Why? Why this happened to me? Why did this? No, he didn't do that. He just got engaged. He loved Rasulullah and he became a Muslim and he served the cause of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Okay, guys. How long we still have? 10 minutes? So now it's the test. What is the name of the father of Zayd? Abdurrahman. اقعد عمر حارثة. Here you go, عمر. ما شاء الله. Okay. How did Zayd became a slave in Mecca? Okay, حسان. Come here, please. Come here, حسان.
His mother took him to his grandfather's town. The town got attacked and the bad people took him to the market as a slave to sell him.
Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar. You get to choose which one.
stick.
All right. What did his mom do after that? What did his mom do? Ahmed. She did what? Can you show me how did she cry? Come here. Can you please come here, show us how did she cry? I mean, I did it. How did she cry, Ahmed? Come on, how did she cry? What did his father do? His father did. You see, at our time, when you lose your child, what do? 911? Hello, police, help me. I lost my son. Okay, I'm going to go to the Facebook, and I'm going to post, have you ever seen my son? You're going to do that. But at this time, it was a desert. There was no Facebook. There was no social media. There was no 911. What was the source of information at the time? Okay, well, okay. Go ahead. Yes. What did he do? Yes, you. Yeah, yeah. You. What did he do? Sarah? Huh? Looking? That's it? I thought I did say that. Okay. What did he do? I want a word, one word, one word. Okay, go ahead. Say it. A poem. Here you go. Yes, he did that. Good job. Takbir. Hana. It's all right. All right, he wrote a poem. Okay. Then what happened after that? How did Zayd came to Khadija? Whoever tells me that. Who's Khadija, the wife of Rasulullah? How did Zayd ended up in Khadija? Go ahead, Abdurrahman. Who bought him first? The nephew. Good job. Yalla, go. Okay. Go ahead. Say it. Sit down. How did Zayd got into Khadija? All right. Here you go. How did Zayd got into Khadija? You don't want to try? How did Zayd got into Khadija? What happened? How did Zayd got into Khadija? Who bought him first? The nephew of Khadija bought him. Good job. All right. Now, how did Zayd's family found out that he's in Mecca? Okay. Back off, please. Back off. Pick me. Okay, go ahead. Go ahead. Try. Go ahead, try. Yalla, because we have to pray Isha, guys. Come on. Okay. No, you already. Okay, who did not? Okay, sit down, please. Mariam, go ahead. How? Go ahead, Mariam. You're going to cheat now? Hanan, go ahead, Hanan. Good job, Hanan. Good job. Mariam doesn't get it. All right. How? Now, Haritha, the father of Zayd, came to Mecca to bring his son back. What did the Prophet offer them instead? What did the Prophet say to them? Okay, Unais, come here. Good job, Unais. Let him make a choice. Good job. Let him make a choice. What did Zayd choose? Okay, sit down, please. Sit down. What did he choose? Choose the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. What did the Prophet do after that in order to make his parents comfortable? Maryam. Zayd ibn Muhammad. Okay, Sarah, did Allah like that? Why? Because we should be named after our parents. All right, Maryam, Sarah, go ahead. Okay, guys, line up, please. Boys, hey. Sheikh Muhammad, خذ يدي البنات الله يبارك. أيوه خلاص.